In the SAP Datasphere Catalog, you can create a glossary template to assist users who create glossary terms. You can also reuse an existing template. The template provides consistency. The template can serve as a reminder about how to create terms. It can also contain custom attributes that may be required for completing the term. In this example, you can see how creating custom attributes for a glossary are transferred to a tab with options the users will see when they create terms in the glossary. For example, you might have specific requirements like an approval process that might differ between sales terms and product terms. Let's create a glossary for products. From the side navigation, choose Catalog. If you cannot see the catalog option, you need to contact your administrator to enable catalog permissions for your user ID. Click the Create button and then choose Glossary. Enter a name and description. Here, we'll enter products and glossary for product terms. In the Reference Template option, you can choose an existing template or create a new template. When we choose an existing glossary, some settings are already made. Click the Custom Attributes tab to see the additional custom settings. In this video, we are going to create our own glossary, so we'll choose the blank option. In the definition area, you can create guidelines for users who create terms. In this example, we've added some guidelines. Users who create the terms can review these notes and then delete the text. To make these guidelines more useful, you can supply prompts for users to complete. Click the Custom Attributes tab to make additional options. These options can be required or optional for the user to complete. Click Add Custom Attributes Group. Enter a group name. These names become tabs when the users are creating a term. You can create additional groups by clicking this plus sign. Each group can have multiple custom attributes in it. Let's create a group called Approval. Click Add Attribute. Enter Approved. This will become the drop-down list with the values True and False. In the Type drop-down list, choose Boolean. We'll leave the default value of having this attribute appear on the left. Switch on required to make this attribute mandatory. Users will know it's mandatory because it will be marked with a red asterisk. We'll quickly add a couple more attributes using the same steps. Click Add Attribute. The name is approved by. In the validation type, we'll choose List of Values. We'll allow multi-select in case we decide that multiple people need to approve the term. This will show checkboxes rather than radio buttons when creating a term. We'll enter some names in the Valid Values option. I press Enter after each name to make a new value. We'll leave the other default values and click OK. Click Add Attribute one more time. The attribute name will be Date Approved. Choose Date from the Type option. Choose to display the option on the right. Accept the rest of the default values, and then click OK. Click Save, and our template is complete. Now I'll show you what it's like when creating a term using this glossary. Click Create, and then Term. From the glossaries list, choose the glossary that we just created. You can see the information from the template on the Definition tab and the Approval tab. Enter a name. You can complete the other options in the header area. On the Approval tab, select True in the approved list. You can also complete the other options. Click Save. For more information about creating catalog glossaries and terms, see help.sap.com. Thanks for watching.